Now, I think the best thing to do is to have a story. You make yourself comfortable, and we'll have a story about an old car. Down under the trees at Manu's place was a very old car. It belonged to Manu's big brother, Honi. The old car had no windscreen, and it had no hood. It had no back bumper, and one of its doors was tied up with string. Somebody had just left the old car in the paddock under the trees. They said it was old and it wouldn't go anymore. And what's the use of an old car that won't go? But Honi was sure he could make it go again. Every day, as soon as he came home from work, he went down under the trees to where the old car stood waiting. He pulled wires and he pushed knobs. He unscrewed things here and tightened things there. Sometimes he had to lie down on his back underneath the car to get at the very tricky parts. Manu and his friend Peter used to watch and hold things. And whenever Honi cranked the engine, they hoped and they hoped that this time it would start. Honi was very big and very strong. He would hold on to the crank handle and push it round and round. When the engine gave a little cough, Honi would run around to the steering wheel and pull levers and push knobs. But the engine would stop just as he got there, and they would all be very disappointed. I can't see why that boy wants to waste so much time fiddling about with that old heap of junk, said Peter's father one day. It's not a heap of junk, said Peter. The old car's just tired. But Honi will make it go. He might even get it going today. Peter's father laughed. We'll see, he said. That afternoon, Peter went over to Manu's place as soon as he'd finished his dinner. It was Saturday, so Honi had the whole afternoon to spend on the old car. Right, he said. Today we get her going. I think I know what's wrong now. Peter and Manu sat in the long grass and watched. Honi lifted the bonnet and fixed something inside the engine. Now, he said. Everybody ready? He pushed the crank handle round and round. And the old car coughed and then stopped, just as it always did. Oh, well, said Honi, we'll just have to try her again. He pulled a few more wires, and once again, he pushed the crank handle round and round. Honi ran quickly round to the driver's seat. But by the time he got there, the engine had stopped again. Honi scratched his head, and everyone looked very disappointed. Suddenly, Honi had an idea. Now listen carefully, everybody, he said. Manu, you sit behind the steering wheel, and when I call right, you pull this lever down and hold it down till I get there. Understand? Yes, said Manu. He felt very grown up sitting in the driver's seat with such an important job to do. Now this time, said Honi. He took hold of the crank handle and pushed it round and round and round. Right, called Home. Manu pulled down the little lever and held it down hard. Smoke poured out the back, and the old car rattled and bounced up and down. Honey ran round, jumped in. Move over, Manu, he shouted above all the noise. Come on, Peter, hop in the other side. They all sat close together in the front seat. Honey pushed the gear lever, and they were off. Bumpity, bumpity, bump, bump, bumpity, bump across the paddock. Everybody came to have a look. Manu's mother and father came out. Peter's mother and father came out. Hooray! She's going at last, called Manu and Peter. Look, everybody, look! Clankety clank, bumpity bump went the old car round and round the paddock. Honey held tight to the steering wheel and smiled a great big smile. It needed you to pull that lever down, Manu, he said. Good old car, I knew you'd go. We'll paint you yellow and give you a new bumper, and you'll be the best car in the whole world.
Goodbye! Bye! Bye!